everyone, thank you so much for joining me today. My name's Chris and this is A Glimpse Inside. Today's episode, we're gonna take something old and give it new life again. Let's get right into it.
All right guys, we're gonna start this project off by using a 4x8 sheet of plywood. I have this stuff stored above my garage. It's the easiest way for me to keep it out of the way. It's a little cumbersome to move around. It's not exactly the lightest thing on the planet, but hey, it gets the job done. Anyway, we start by making a cut here. I'm gonna rip it at right around 21 inches or so and then come back later on and cut two pieces at 10 inches wide. Okay, well here's the something old I referred to in the intro. This is an old vintage window. I'm not sure when it's from, maybe the 1940s or 50s. It needs a little bit of work, but we're gonna leave it mostly rustic. We're gonna take off the hardware now. Once that's removed, we're gonna give it a light sanding. And then I'm gonna run one edge through the table saw. This is not exactly the safest thing to do, but just take your time, be safe. Everything should go fine. All right, we make a couple measurements here. My measurements, of course, came from the window. I'm making the tops and bottoms of the cases here, and I'm gonna cut them here at the chop saw. And woodworking is sometimes about making mistakes and then fixing the mistakes. I realized that my index mark is shy of two pieces of plywood. If I had cut these where I'd originally intended, the case would have been too big and the window would not have fit. So luckily I caught it. Now here's everything you need to make this project happen. We got tops, bottoms, we got shelves, we got the window.
Okay, I want to explain something real quick. In that last shot, it was everything you need to put this thing together. There's two pieces in there I want to explain though. These, okay? These are basically shelf pin jigs. This one I bought at Woodcraft or Rockler or one of those places. This one I made a while back. Typically the ones you buy come with this drill bit. This drill bit has a sleeve on it and that bit itself is the exact same diameter as these little shelf pins. Again, the part by my fingers goes in the wood, the shelf rests on that little ledge there in all four sections. The drill bit's pretty cool. It actually works where you put this inside there, and as you drill, it drills into the wood just enough to give you enough room to put those shelf pins in. Anyway, just wanted to explain that. Moving on, let's go.
All right, so here's the actual shelf pin jig in action. The drill bit I spoke of earlier has a collar that rests in these holes, and it plunges down, giving you a cut just shy of 3/4 of an inch, perfect for 3/4 inch plywood. You might be wondering how come I'm not drilling a hole every single hole all the way up and down this cabinet. Well, I've done that before and I didn't really need the options to put shelves everywhere within the cabinet. Once I usually put the cabinet in place, put the shelves in place, that was probably where I left it for the duration of the time. I've moved them a couple times, but I never needed all those holes. So what I find is that typically three holes in the middle, top, and bottom of the cabinet is perfect for shelf placement. And every option I've ever needed is within those. Well, there you go, perfect fit every time. Okay, so I got a vintage window that I'm making a cabinet from, and this is relatively new plywood, and those two materials don't match. So we're gonna do our best to kind of distress this plywood a little bit. I got an ice pick, I got an old hammer, and I'm gonna use my angle grinder to kind of burn some marks in it too as well. So we keep distressing this thing, and I particularly like this little technique here where you take your angle grinder and you make a series of cuts over and over and over. I'm not really sure exactly what that represents, but after I apply a coat of stain on this thing, those little imperfections look pretty authentic. Oh, guess what? You know what time it is. Time for some sanding. Every woodworker's favorite thing to do. If you could see my face at the moment, you would see smile from ear to ear. beaming with sarcasm. This process is a necessary evil, but now it's time for some assembly. What I've done here is I've made a couple little, I don't know what you call these things, I guess brackets or holders, if you will. They kind of hold the pieces in place while I tack them with some 1 1/4 inch brads, little tight bond, little glue, any PVA glue will work. And we start putting this thing together. Now, for what it's worth, let's talk about pneumatic air gun storage. I recently put this thing above my head in this little bracket that rests against my plywood storage. It's made my workflow so much better. The hose isn't constantly being tripped over. Everything's out of the way. One of the best decisions I've made as of late as it pertains to my shop. Well, as you can see here, I'm reinforcing these joints with screws and the ply split. So a little glue, a little CA glue. I clamp it shut with a squeeze clamp and then put a little activator on it. And by the time I get those three screws screwed in, that activator has gotten hold and that joint is completely fixed. Okay, time for a 45 degree angle French cleat to be installed. The French cleat system is two intersecting 45 degree angle pieces of wood that is one of my favorite ways to attach any cabinet to a wall. It makes the process very simple, as you'll see at the end. I reinforced this joint with some screws, and I'm gonna go ahead and make sure that this piece, before I get too carried away, is square. Taking the diagonal measurements, it's spot on. I like to give a shout out to one of my favorite podcasts as of late. If you're not listening to the Making It podcast by Bob, Jimmy, and David, well, you're missing out. If you make things with your hands, these guys have unbelievable insight onto life in general, but a lot of it pertains to people who are makers and people who are thinkers and creative minds, so it's awesome. It's inspiring, definitely worth a listen. I'll put the link in the description below. All right, quick little trick here. I like to cut my piano hinge in half. I'm gonna use part of it for the top, part of it for the bottom, and it's gonna be plenty strong for the hinges that are needed to swing this door in and out. I place the hinge on the window and the cabinet, make a mark with a pencil, come back with an ice pick, that way my drill bit doesn't wander, and I go ahead and install these screws. I do the same thing on the other side, and we're in business. All right, here comes the moment of truth. I put it on and it works. So it's always nice to see a plan come together. Piece of craft paper is what I need now. I'm gonna start applying some stain. I made this little Lazy Susan painter's triangle thing. I love it, it works great. You can spin pieces of wood and stain doesn't stick to it and works out great. I'm using a dark stain here. Dark stain typically works best for me when I have decided to distress a new piece of wood that I'm trying to make look gold, as we're doing here. Once you put that dark stain on it, you really start to see those imperfections come to life. Once all the stain is applied with a brush, I come back with a shop towel and take off the excess. Now you can kind of see here that these spots that I made look a little bit better than they did when they were just on raw wood. Again, it's replicating old wood. It's not perfect. In this case, I like it. My wife likes it. We're happy with the result. After all, this piece is for her. It's going in her studio. I'll explain more about that later. Now, my finish of choice here is paste wax, furniture wax. I don't really want a high luster, high shine finish on this thing due to the fact of its rustic nature. So you flood the surface with some wax and you come back and you wipe it off with a clean cloth. Turns out to be a very nice kind of matte finish for the whole project. I'm even putting the same application on the shelves, and here they are so far. That's shirt, okay? You gotta read it correctly. Anyway, I realized when I cut this wood off this window, it left some exposed wood, so I'm kind of darkening up and aging it with some dark stain now. Okay, putting the door back together, putting the cabinet back together, and it looks like it's gonna work out pretty well. I'm installing those shelf pins and I'm pleased. Now, I've gotta come up with a way to attach the door to the cabinet when it shuts to keep it from opening, to give itself a secure fit. So instead of using magnets, what I'm trying here is taking some brass rod, two pieces, and sharpening each one. I'm then gonna take a drill bit and drill 1/4 inch down on the top and bottom of the cabinet. Simply use some CA glue,
put the brass pins in. The sharp tip is a reference point where I'm gonna make an indentation in the door so then I can drill a hole. And when this door shuts, those pins fit right in there. Nice, nice snug fit. All right, now it's time to clean this bad boy up. There's still some residual dirt on it from where we got it. And I'm putting the old piece of hardware back on. I'm really liking how this project is turning out. All right, well, here we go. Time to install it. That French cleat going up on the wall, I'm using drywall anchors here due to the fact the studs in the wall weren't exactly where I needed them. But these drywall anchors are 75 pounds a piece. We should have no problem putting this up and it holding the weight. Well, we are extremely happy with how this turned out. The little knickknacks inside here are just kind of an illustration of what you can do. You could take an old window, make a cabinet out of it. It turned out beautiful. Hey guys, thank you so much for joining me for this one. This was a fun one. This was a project that kind of demonstrates what old doesn't always have to stay that way. We took an old window and we gave it new life by putting it with a newer display case that looks old. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me on this one. This is actually a part of six that I'm gonna make to go in my wife's studio. We're gonna make six of these that's gonna store all of her supplies in her studio to kind of keep with that vintage theme that she has going on there. Guys, if you liked it, please give me a thumbs up down below. Consider subscribing if this is your first time here. And thank you so much for watching. Comment, please, as well. I appreciate the feedback, and we'll see you on the next one. Have a great one. Bye.